What is up, beautiful people? It's your girl, Nicole Young, and I am back with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about project-based learning. And before I jump into today's video, I wanted to let you know that I have taken on the 100 Days of Code challenge, and I post updates to my Instagram. So if you are interested in joining me in that challenge, make sure you go over to Instagram and hit that follow button. But also, I have a private Facebook group where some of my friends and followers who are also taking the challenge are on there, and we are encouraging each other, sharing our resources, and just making sure that we are staying motivated and pressing forward. If you're interested in joining that 100 Days of Code challenge, it doesn't matter what day you are on, definitely check out the link in the description and join us. So what is project-based learning? So project-based learning is the process of learning through actually building real-world problems and taking on projects that will help to challenge you and develop your skills as a coder. This will help you to understand how certain concepts and functions and structures come together and work together to build the complex problems that you want to take on as a developer. So here's why I think that project-based learning is the right way to go and is a better way to go about learning, especially if you're self-taught, than any other methods. The first reason is that I believe that project-based learning makes learning fun. It makes it a lot more encouraging being able to have the feedback of seeing a project come together instead of just the random problems that you get to solve on like online courses or in books. You are actually seeing a project come together. You're seeing the interface come together. You're seeing the back-end things start to work as you test them. And that is super rewarding, and it will continue to encourage you. I think that project-based learning has really changed the way that I approach my coding, and it makes it a lot more fun. I'm excited to get to sit down and start building a project because I know, oh, I have to add these new things to the project, or I'm starting to see it come together. So it's like really exciting to want to see the final product. And so it keeps you motivated and it keeps pushing through those tougher challenges and the tougher things that happen. A second reason why I think project-based learning is so great to incorporate into your learning process is because project-based learning can help you to connect the dots between the things that you're learning, and it can help bring meaning to the concepts and constructs that you learn in most languages. So things like for loops and if-else statements, things like that. It's really, you know, easy to learn those things as standalone structures and concepts, but being able to actually conceptualize as a beginner what those things will be useful for in coding projects is going to help you so much more than just understanding how a for loop works and understanding how to put one together. I used to be a hiring manager for the last tech company that I worked for, and one thing that I will say, it's a lot better to show that you have experience with something than just tell and say that you have experience in something. So saying that you have experience with Python isn't going to be as effective or stand out as much as being able to show that you built something in Python that uses a lot of the concepts and frameworks and things that go along with that language. So my advice to you is to start using project-based learning immediately. Start building projects that are helping you to learn, but also helping you to beef up your portfolio. Stay curious and allow yourself to think up projects that you can build on your own. And don't be afraid to tackle projects that may seem too big for you. I have a ton of ideas of apps and things that I want to build that absolutely scare me because I don't know the first place to start with them, but I'm starting small with some smaller projects and going to work my way up to those things to gain confidence and to continue to build my resume. And I'm gonna get to those things and I'm actually gonna build them. And that's what being a developer is all about, isn't it? Just challenging yourself and pushing your limits and creating some new and awesome things. So Leave a comment below if you have tried project-based learning or if you definitely are going to incorporate it into your current processes. Make sure that you hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell so that you don't miss another video because I upload new videos every single week. Make sure you check out the links down in the description for more resources on project-based learning and how you can join my 100 Days of Code private Facebook group. I will see you guys in the next video. I love you.